Hello, fitness enthusiasts. Welcome to Muscle Mode. We're thrilled to have you join us on this journey to optimum fitness. Our mission is to provide you with top-notch fitness content that helps you make the most out of your workouts. So don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel to stay updated with our latest videos. Are you ready to engage every muscle in your body and push your limits? Let's get moving. Let's start with a great exercise for the chest, the incline dumbbell bench press. This exercise is a fantastic way to target your upper chest and shoulders, and it's a staple in any good workout routine. To perform the incline dumbbell press, start by sitting on an incline bench with a dumbbell in each hand at shoulder level. Your feet should be flat on the floor and your back should be firmly against the bench. Push the weights up until your arms are fully extended, but don't lock your elbows. Then slowly lower the weights back to the starting position. The incline dumbbell bench press is all about control. The slower you lower the weights, the more you'll engage your chest muscles. This exercise is great for building strength and size in your upper chest, and it also works your shoulders and triceps. Remember, proper form is key to maximizing the benefits of this exercise. Next, we have the shoulder press, a fantastic exercise for the shoulders. To perform this exercise, start by standing tall with your feet shoulder width apart. Hold a dumbbell in each hand at shoulder level, with your palms facing forward. Now push the weights upward until your arms are fully extended above your head. Pause for a moment at the top, then slowly lower the weights back down to shoulder level. The shoulder press is a compound exercise, meaning it works multiple muscle groups at once. It primarily targets the deltoids, but also engages the triceps and upper back. This exercise helps to build strength and stability in the upper body, which is essential for everyday activities that involve lifting or reaching. Remember, it's not about how much weight you can lift, but about performing the exercise with proper form. Focus on maintaining a straight back and engaging your core throughout the movement. Keep your movements controlled for the best results. Now let's move to the tricep dips, an excellent exercise for your triceps. This workout is all about control and form, allowing you to target your triceps effectively. To start, position your hands shoulder width apart on a secured bench or stable chair. Extend your legs out in front of you. Slowly lower your body by bending your elbows until you reach a 90-degree angle. Make sure your back remains close to the bench during this motion. Once you hit that angle, push your body back up to the starting position. That's one rep. Tricep dips do wonders for your upper body strength, particularly enhancing your triceps. They also engage your shoulders and chest, making it a comprehensive upper body workout. One thing to note, your core plays a key role in this exercise. Engaging your core will help you maintain balance and stability, enhancing the effectiveness of the tricep dips. Remember to engage your core for stability. Pull-ups are up next, a classic exercise for the back. They're a tried and true staple of any workout routine, and for good reason. When done correctly, pull-ups engage multiple muscle groups at once, providing a comprehensive workout for your upper body, especially your back. Let's talk about the proper way to do them. Start by hanging from a pull-up bar with your hands shoulder width apart. Your palms should be facing away from you. Pull yourself up until your chin is above the bar, keeping your body straight and your core engaged. Lower yourself down slowly, controlling your descent rather than just dropping. This movement targets your latissimus dorsi, the large muscles on either side of your back, as well as your rhomboids and trapezius. These muscles are key for good posture and upper body strength. Pull-ups can be challenging, but they're worth the effort. Remember, consistency is key. Keep your movements smooth and steady. Let's pump those biceps with some bicep curls. An all-time favorite move, bicep curls are all about engaging the upper arm muscles for that coveted bulging effect. Grab your weights, stand tall with your feet hip-width apart, and let your arms hang down by your sides. Your palms should be facing forward, and your elbows should be close to your torso. Now, keeping your upper arm stationary, curl the weights while contracting your biceps. Breathe out as you do this, and make sure your movements are smooth, not jerky. The upper part of the lift should be the part where your biceps are contracted to the max, and they should be fully flexed. Once you reach the top, take a pause, then gradually lower the weights back down. That's one rep. Remember, the lowering phase is just as important as the lift. It's all about control and movement, not speed. Maintain a controlled pace for maximum muscle engagement. Hammer curls, a great exercise for strengthening the forearms. To perform this exercise, you'll need a pair of dumbbells. Now stand up straight, holding the dumbbells at arm's length. Keep your elbows close to your torso and ensure your palms are facing your torso. This will be your starting position. Now, while holding the upper arm stationary, curl the weights while contracting your biceps. Continue to raise the weights until your biceps are fully contracted and the dumbbells are at shoulder level. Hold the contracted position for a brief pause as you squeeze your biceps. Then, slowly begin to bring the dumbbells back to starting position. What makes hammer curls a great forearm workout? It's all about the grip. The neutral grip you adopt during this exercise places greater emphasis on the brachioradialis, a muscle of the forearm. Remember, consistency is key. So incorporate hammer curls into your routine and watch your forearm strength increase over time. Let's target those abs with some flutter kicks. This exercise is a great way to engage your core, particularly the lower abdominal muscles. To perform a flutter kick, start by lying flat on your back. Extend your legs fully, lifting them slightly off the ground. Keeping your abs engaged, start to alternately lift each leg in a fluttering up and down motion. Imagine you're kicking water in a pool. It's crucial to keep your back flat against the ground throughout the exercise. If you're arching your back, lower your legs a bit to make it easier. Flutter kicks are a great way to strengthen your core muscles, improve stability, and boost your overall fitness. They target the lower abs, but also engage your upper abs and hip flexors. This makes them a great all-around ab exercise. Remember, it's not about speed, but control. The slower and more controlled your movements, the more your abs have to work. Keep pushing, you're doing great. Next up, dumbbell squats, an excellent exercise for the quads. This dynamic move targets the large muscles in your legs, including the quadriceps, making it a powerhouse of an exercise. To begin, stand tall with your feet hip-width apart. Hold a dumbbell in each hand, arms fully extended, and palms facing your body. This is your starting position. Now, brace your core and lower your body into a squat by pushing your hips back and bending your knees as if you were sitting in a chair. Make sure your knees don't go past your toes. Go as low as you can, keeping your chest up and your gaze forward. Push through your heels to return to the starting position, squeezing your glutes at the top. Congratulations! You've just completed one rep. This exercise not only strengthens your quads, but also improves your balance and mobility. So don't be shy to add dumbbell squats to your leg day routine. Remember, depth is key in squats. Romanian deadlifts, a powerful exercise for the glutes and hamstrings. This move is all about hinging at the hips, keeping your back straight, and driving through your heels. Start by standing tall, feet hip-width apart, with a barbell or pair of dumbbells in your hands. Your palms should be facing your body. Now push your hips back as if you're trying to shut a car door with your butt. Keep your chest up and back straight as you lower the weights down the front of your legs. Go as far as your flexibility allows, but stop if you feel your lower back start to round. That's your hamstrings telling you they've reached their limit. Then, squeeze your glutes and push your hips forward to return to standing. That's one rep. This exercise is great for building strength and muscle in your lower body, particularly your glutes and hamstrings. Plus, it can help improve your posture and prevent lower back pain. Keep your form tight and controlled. Lastly, let's work those calves with some calf raises. Stand tall, pressing down into the balls of both feet to raise your body upward. Keep your abdominal muscles pulled in so that you move straight upward, not swaying forward or backward. Lower back down slowly for one rep. This simple yet effective exercise targets your calf muscles, boosting strength and enhancing muscle definition. And that's a wrap. Remember, consistency is key in fitness. Keep pushing, and you'll see results.